Hello foodies, welcome to Foodie Rules. This is Varshif back with another most requested recipe, that is chiffon cake or basic sponge cake. Here you can see my sponge cake turned out very well. It is soft and also very spongy. As usual, I'm gonna post all the list of ingredients and the measurements, also the link to buy them in the description below. So first I'm gonna make my oven setup. For that, in a pressure cooker I've added 2.5 cups of salt. I've arranged the salt in such a way that the corners have more salt and the bottom has less salt. Then I'm gonna place a plate like thing so that to just maintain a distance between the cake tin and the base, I mean the salt. So I'm going to preheat on high flame for 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, we'll be ready with our batter also. So just we need to preheat with the lid on top, without the whistle. So for the dry ingredients, I've taken 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour or maida, in which I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, and I'm going to whisk it. For the aeration, I've taken 3 egg whites. So into the egg whites, I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of cream of tartar. If you don't have cream of tartar, you can also use salt. Then I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Then I'm going to whip it on high speed. You can also use a hand whisk, but it takes a lot of time. So meanwhile, when you are whipping it, you need to add 1/2 and 1/4 cup of powdered sugar, little by little, and you need to make a fluffy aeration out of it. You can see here how fluffy our egg whites turn out. So then in a large mixing bowl, you need to add 3 egg yolks. So into this egg yolks, you need to add 1/2 cup of oil. You need to use flavored oil so that it just works well without any excess flavor. Then you need to add 1/2 cup of milk. Then you need to whip it first around 2 minutes or so. Then after that, you need to add our dry ingredients little by little. Then you need to mix it using a rubber spatula or else a silicone spatula as per your preference. Then just incorporate all the dry ingredients and make a lump-free dough, like lump-free batter out of it. Take your own time for it. So when you are done, you need to add 1/3 portion of your aeration. So you need to divide the portion into 3 parts, and then you need to mix the aeration with the batter in cut and fold method only. So by using cut and fold method, we'll be getting a good batter. So this small announcement guys, I'm gonna come live on YouTube on October 27 as per your preference, like as per your request, at 8 PM IST. We'll be enjoying, so just attend it. Then I'm going to mix the batter in cut and fold method only. So last portion comes here. Again, I'm going to mix it. So in the same way, you need to mix guys, or else you'll lose all the aeration which you have earned before. So you can see here, our batter will turn out into white in color rather than being yellow. So next, I've taken a spring form cake tin. You can also use a normal cake tin, aluminium cake tin. Just I've applied some butter and a parchment paper at the bottom, and I'm going to pour all the batter into it and just dab a little bit so that we'll be getting rid of that excess big holes. Then I'm going to place a small plate in the pressure cooker as shown in the video. Then I'm going to place my batter or my cake tin, so be careful or else you may burn. So you need to bake it around 30 minutes in low flame only. So when you're keeping a toothpick inside the cake, it should come clean off. Then our cake is ready. Then we need to let the cake cool inside the tin itself. It will take around 10 to 15 minutes, that will be fine. Then you need to remove it, and you can see our cake is so spongy. And then you need to make it upside down and remove the parchment paper or the butter paper which I have kept. Slowly remove it and then enjoy your cake. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. All the links are in the description box below. So until then, goodbye.